Let's start recording. So welcome again. Like I said, while I'm trying to get a few last minute people in with reminders, I have a question that I'm going to put in the chat that I'd like everybody to try and answer. The question is, what is the biggest difference you can think of between a play and a movie? All right. Think about that. And if you have an answer, you can put it in the chat. You can also come off mute if you want and let us know verbally. But think about that for a few minutes here while I try and round up some more folks to join us. Hey, Ike, good morning to you. Good to see you in here. Glad your links are working, at least for today. Hopefully they stay that way. All right, so again, I'll put this question in the chat one more time since we have some new people joining us. But we're thinking about what is the biggest difference we can think of between a play and a movie. Relisha says a play is live performance and a movie is recorded. Definitely, that is one. Talia said the stage and the settings. So that's another one, right? One takes place live on stage. The other one is recorded. We see it in the theater after it's cut and edited and things like that. Definitely, I think those are kind of two of the biggest ones, right? When we see a movie, we know that, you know, all of this has been pre-recorded and edited, and if they make a mistake, they can kind of, you know, start again, versus, a play is live action, it's performed in real time, you're sitting there watching it happen. Anything else that comes to mind? Differences between plays and movies? Do we think then maybe one is harder to do than the other because, you know, one's happening in real time being performed and the other one is pre-recorded and edited and stuff like that? Or do we think they're both kind of equally difficult? What do we think? Is one maybe harder than the other? Think about what we've already talked about. Okay, one, you have to perform on stage in front of a live audience. Right? The other one, we recorded ahead of time, then we can cut, we can edit, we can do things like that. So does one seem like maybe it'd be harder to do than the other? Or do we think they're both equally difficult? What do we think? That's a good point there, Talia. People get paid way more for movies. Why do you think that is? Why do you think that is? Why do you think that is, that people get paid more for movies than for plays? And can I also say that I think they're both difficult because, you know, movies go to different senses, and on a play people have to keep the show going. Yeah, I like how you said movies go to different senses, because are you saying, you know, because we're watching it, so it's appealing to kind of everything at once when we see it in the theater, versus like when we watch a play? Yeah, that's a really good point. Can I, you know, think about like a 3D movie or something like Avengers, where it's all this action and we're hearing it and we're seeing it and we can see all those special effects, versus like in a play, some of that stuff has to be imagined sometimes, right? Because we can only do so much, right? And to least every time a movie gets played, they get paid. Yes, so that's a big part of the reason, right? Is because movies reach a wider audience, because a play only takes place where? In that one theater, right? So like when Hamilton was on Broadway, if you wanted to see Hamilton, you could only see it at that one spot at the Richard Rogers Theater. That's why, you know, the tickets, you know, are so expensive. But now it's on Disney Plus, so you can see it whenever you want. But a movie like Avengers or something like that, you know, like Talia said, they could play it everywhere, and you know, tens of millions of theaters across the country sometimes. So that also means that all those actors and directors and writers, all their work is being showed all those times too. So they deserve, you know, to get paid each time, like Talia said. So I think that's part of the reason. Then, you know, also you have all the marketing and stuff that goes with it. But that doesn't necessarily mean one is harder than the other, right? It just means maybe there's more benefits to one versus the other. It's a really good point. All right. And I, like you said, also definitely costs more to make, right? You know, think about, again, like we said, like Kanai said, it appeals to all those senses because you have all those special effects and stuff. So something like Avengers Endgame is going to cost much more to make than, you know, if you were putting on a production of Romeo and Juliet or something like that. Okay. So we've talked about differences. What are, now that we've thought about those, the last thing I want us to think about here for this part of the morning is, what are the similarities, if I can remember how to type, between play and movie? All right. What are the similarities between a play and a movie? What do they both have? All right. And welcome to our celebrity guest, Miss Kelsey. We are discussing similarities and differences between plays and movies so far.
It's always interesting when they make a play into a movie, or like actually do a movie as though it were a play. It's weird.
Yeah, that's actually what we're going to talk about a little bit later today. Miss Kelsey is shadowing for us. But what do we think? What are some of those similarities? We talked about the differences, right? One is live action in front of an audience. One's pre-recorded. You can edit and cut, things like that. One appeals to, you know, multiple senses with special effects and everything. You know, the actors have to kind of keep everything going. So this is the differences. What are the similarities? Hey, Zanelia, good morning to you. All right. Those of you who are just joining us, we're talking about similarities and differences of plays and movies. I'll put it in the chat again. All right. We talked about the differences already. So now what are the similarities? What are things that both a play and a movie can have? All right, they both have scenes, right, Zanelia? Definitely. What else? You know, like we can start with the easy ones. They both have scenes. They both have actors, right? They both have directors. But what else? Anything else come to mind?
You're talking about similarities or differences or similarities?
Talking about similarities right now, yes. think about what they both have, what they both start from. Like before you see Avengers up on the screen or before you see a play in the theater, you know, they both have to start with something that somebody writes. Yes, a script. Right. Thank you. Yeah, definitely. They both have scripts, right? And that is going to kind of be the key here in this project, is we're going to look at, you know, the script of a movie and, you know, how that translates from the page onto the stage, if it were a play, or the screen, right? Do we keep some things? Do we lose some things? Do they both tell the story effectively? Is one more effective than the other? And that's going to kind of be the point here. But they both, you know, even though we've talked about what the differences are, at the end of the day, they both start with a script because they're both telling a story. These are both, you know, narrative instruments, right? So what we're going to do today is actually decide which movie we are actually going to use for our film study. And they are both movies based on plays, right? They're both movies based on plays by August Wilson, who is a very famous African-American playwright, popular in the 70s and 80s. And when we think about, you know, key figures in theater, specifically key African-American figures in theater, he's definitely at the top of the list, all right? And we also have, for the first question, our differences. Kanaya said, when you mess up in a movie, you can fix it. When you mess up in a play, the show just goes on regardless. Yeah, that's key too. I think that's also one of the biggest differences is, you know, in a movie, you can cut and edit and you can fix it if you make a mistake. But in a play, you got to keep going, right? And sometimes that's good and sometimes that can be bad, right? Really good point.
All right. Can I like go off of that and share an experience that I've had too?
Of course.
Okay. So, you guys know me as a counselor, but before I knew I wanted to be a counselor, I thought I wanted to be an English teacher like Mr. V and Miss Christina. And so I'd gone back to school for English, and my school was in the summer, and we had an acting troupe that would come in every summer with us, and they would put on a play at the end of the summer. So they would practice all summer and they would come into our classrooms and stuff and do other things, but mostly they put on a play. So one year they put on Hamlet, and there's this famous scene where they're at this grave and there's a grave digger and he digs up a skull and he sort of like tosses it over to Hamlet. And in the play that they were producing, they, you know, they had this guy like throw a fake skull down this little stairs and then it would roll around, and sometimes it would go into the audience and everything. But the night that I watched it, the skull like bounced down the stairs, rolled around Hamlet, and like ended up right in front of him. And the actor who was playing him was like so amazed that he was like, "Will you look at that?" Like, it was so amazing. And I think just to Kanaya's point where you can mess up and fix it in a movie, there are also unanticipated, like amazing things that happen in plays that you can't, like you could never have that. Yeah, it was pretty great. It was like, it was wild. And the next year they did a different play and the place lost power. So they did the whole play by candlelight, which is like, that just will never happen in the movies. So I right. think Kanaya, like what you were saying is like movies, you can fix those difference, those like mistakes, but you also kind of lose like any magical element that might happen that makes it a once in a lifetime performance.
Yeah, that was really cool. I remember this, that reminded me of when I was in high school, I was in the marching band. I was in the drum line because I was, you know, super cool. And there was our band director conducted the band for a local theater in one of the like neighboring counties, and he would conduct the pit orchestra every season for like their seasonal musical. And the one year they put on the musical called The Music Man. And at the end of that, if you've never seen it, at the end of that musical, there is like the main character leads like a parade with a marching band. And so our high school marching band got to be the marching band that comes out. And but nobody knew, like, it was a surprise each show. Like, the people didn't know there was going to be a real live marching band there. So we would come like halfway through the show, and then we would like have our uniforms on, and then we would like march down the aisles of the theater, and then we would stop and we would play a song, and then we would like march back. And it was super good. It was super fun, super cool. And again, one of those things, like Miss Kelsey said, where, you know, that's what can happen in play that, you know, won't happen, that like you don't get that kind of experience from a movie theater. It was very lit, Kanaya, if I'm being honest.
I like your enthusiasm, Kanaya. Thank you.
Yes. Yeah, it was cool. But I think to Kanaya's earlier point about appealing to different senses, it goes the other way too with movies, right? Where like, okay, so that's something that's happening live in person. That's really cool. But then, man, it is coming down out there. But then when we think about, you know, something about like the Marvel universe, right? So that's like when Avengers Endgame came out, that's 22 movies that are all interconnected that lead up to this one thing. And I remember when we went to see Avengers Endgame that night, it was kind of like the culmination of all of this. And, you know, we were saying like, we might not ever have a movie going experience like this, at least in our lives again, where something, there's a franchise that's this interconnected over 10, 11 years that builds up to this point that everybody is so emotionally invested in, right? And while you get emotionally invested in a play, I don't think you can get it to that level where it's spanned, you know, a couple years. And like, you know, maybe, you know, there were people that when the first Iron Man came out in 2008, now maybe they have young children. And so they're going to see Avengers Endgame with, and it's like that kind of thing, right? So I think that's where, on the other side with movies, because they reach a larger audience, you can have experiences like that. So I think it goes on both sides. But those are both really good points. And I think when you talk about movies based on plays, that's where we can kind of put them both together, right? So here's what we're going to do now, all right? I'm going to put a link in the chat. And this link should bring you to a Nearpod page, all right? Let me share my screen here. And when you get to the Nearpod page, you should see something that looks very much like this, okay? With this kind of trailer screen on the landing page, all right? So what I want you to do is hit that link and go ahead and sign into the Nearpod. I'll give everybody a minute or two to do this, all right? Who else just joined us? Hey, Jairi, welcome. All right. Oop. Shoot. So again, go ahead and click that Nearpod link. Sign in there. I'll put it in the chat to you, Jairi, since you just joined. I'll give everybody, like I said, a few minutes here to get signed into the Nearpod. You shouldn't need a code if you click that link, but if you do, let me know, and I will put that in the chat as well. All right. Excuse me, but go ahead and get signed into the Nearpod. Miss Kelsey, you can do so as well if you would like to follow along. All right. Hit that link, type in your name, and then you will be registered in there. So let's try and get everybody onto that Nearpod if we can. In the next few minutes here, I have Miss Kelsey in there. I have Jairi in there already. Thank you. All right. All right. I'm going to wait until we have just about everybody in there, all right, if we can, because we do have a pretty full house here today, which is excellent. Thank you. All right. So again, if you are able to go ahead and head to that Nearpod link, you should be able to do it on your phone if you're on your phone. All right. Hey, Manaya, good morning. Welcome. Thank you for joining. All right. Look at this. We're getting everybody in here tonight. Hey. I think we got anybody new. I think it was just somebody coming back in. All right. So, Manaya, I'm going to put this link to you in the chat as well since you just joined.
Where are you? Okay.
There we go. All right. So, go ahead. Click that link. It should take you to the Nearpod. Go ahead and sign in. All right. I have Jairi in there. I have Kira in there. All right. I have Nalia in there. So let's give it maybe another minute or two to see if we can get everybody else logged in. And then we can go through this together. Like I said, shouldn't need a code if you click that link that I put in the chat. And then when you pull up the Nearpod, it should look very similar to this. And go ahead, put in your name, and then we should be ready to go.
It's a code.
You shouldn't need a code, but if you do, just in case, I will put it in the chat for everybody. If you click the link I put in the chat, you shouldn't need a code. But if for some reason it asks you for one, I'm going to put it in the chat now for everybody. All right, so there's your code, TQM64. All right. Manaya is in, Jairi are in, thank you, all right? We would maybe one more minute get everybody else in there.
Right. Mr. V, you are reaching one of your goals for this semester, which is to use Nearpod more and make it interactive.
I know, thank you for reminding me. I'm trying at least. All right, like I said, give me about another minute. If you're still not in the Nearpod, try and get there now. Looks like we got a few more in there. Kanaya is in, Ike is in there. Excellent. All right. Very cool. All right, we'll go ahead and get started because it looks like we got Alicia's in there. Looks like we got just about everybody. Okay. If you're still having trouble, let me know in the chat, but you should be good. So what I'm going to do now is share my screen here, okay? And as you can see on your Nearpod, there are two movie trailers that we're going to watch, right? Like I said, both of these movies are movies based on plays by August Wilson. What we're going to do is we're going to watch each trailer, and then you're going to fill out a poll at the end as to which of these movies you would rather use for our film study. Okay, so here's the first one. This play is called Fences, right? And this is probably August Wilson's most famous play that won him the Pulitzer Prize, which is the most prestigious award that a playwright in America can receive. All right, so here we go. Let me make sure everybody can hear this one.
Ask you a question? How come you ain't never like me? Like you? What law is there say I got to like you? No. All right then. Don't you eat every day? Answer me when I talk to you. Don't you eat every day?
Yeah.
As long as you're in my house, you put a sir on the end of it when you talk to me.
Yes, sir.
You eat every day.
Yes, sir.
Got a roof over your head.
Yes, sir.
Got clothes on your back.
Yes, sir.
Why you think that is?
Because of you.
Hell, I know it's because of me, but why do you think that is?
Because you like me?
Like you. I go out of here every morning. I bust my butt because I like you. You're about the biggest fool I ever saw. A man is supposed to take care of his family. You live in my house, fill your belly with my food, put you behind on my bed because you're my son. It's my duty to take care of you. I owe a responsibility to you. I ain't got to like you. Now, I don't give you everything I got to give you. I give you your life. Me and your mama worked that out. Between us, and liking your black ass wasn't part of the bargain. Now, don't you go through life worrying about whether somebody like you or not. You best be making sure that they're doing right by you. You understand what I'm saying?
Everything that boy do, he do for you.
It's not easy for me to admit that I've been standing in the same place for 18 years.
Well, I've been standing with you. I gave 18 years of my life to stand in the same spot as you.
Right, so there is trailer number one. Let's keep that in mind. Right, and now we'll go to trailer number two. So this is a movie called Ma Rainey's Black Bottom. So you can see kind of some familiar faces already. So Viola Davis is in both movies. She actually won the Oscar for her performance in the Fences. All right, and she's in this movie too. And this is also, you can recognize Chadwick Boseman from Black Panther and all that other stuff. This was his last movie he made before he passed away. Okay, and again, this is based on another one of August Wilson's plays. So here we go with trailer number two.
A one, a two, a you know what to do. Let's be an empty world without the blues. I try to take that emptiness and fill it up with something. But they want to call me Father Blues, that's all right with me. It don't hurt none.
Where's the horn player?
I got a friend.
Come on, Libby. You rehearse like everybody else.
I'm going to get me a band and make me some records. I know how to play real music, not this jazz band shit.
They call it playing music.
I know what I'm doing. No one will find me, I don't care.
When I got there, they began to say,
that's to get the people's attention. That's when you and Slow Drag come in with the rhythm part. Me and Cutler play on the break.
I'm assuming you understand it, and what you say is what Ma said to count.
We'll be ready to go in 15 minutes.
We'll be ready to go, madam says we're ready to go, and that's the way it go around here.
These records are going to be hits.
Every colored man in the world got to do his part. I'm going to tell the white man just what he can do.
They don't care nothing about me. All they want. In my voice.
About them songs I give you.
They're not the right songs.
I don't take them off your hands for you.
I got my time coming.
You don't know nothing about what kind of blood I got. What kind of heart I got being here. Come on!
All right, so there's trailer number two. Okay. So now here's what I would like you to do. You should now see. A poll come up on your Nearpod that says, which movie based on one of August Wilson's plays would you rather watch? All right. Fences or Ma Rainey's Black Bottom. I remember Fences was the first trailer we saw with that had Denzel Washington in it. And Ma Rainey's Black Bottom was the second trailer that we just watched that had Chadwick Boseman in. Okay. So go ahead, fill out this poll now. All right. Select your best answer. Once everybody fills this out, we'll jump ahead to our next task here for today. And while you guys are filling this out, just to let you guys know what's going on, I'm going to use the results of this poll. I'm going to look at the results from all the other sections of my drama class and then see what the overwhelming majority selected. And that's going to be the movie that we use for our film study. Okay. So go ahead, fill this out. I only got about, we got some more coming in. All right. Thank you. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. All right. So still need one from Ike and Kira. And Miss Kelsey, you can go ahead and answer the poll too. Why not?
All right, I just put it in.
All right, awesome. Thank you. All right, we'll get about another maybe 30 seconds here. Okay. So while the rest of us are finishing up that poll, and then I will share the results with you. All right. I'm also going to put another link in the chat. Okay. And at this link I'm putting in the chat, I'd like you to head to that article. And I will share my screen here in a second and show you what it should look like. All right. So let's do this real quick. All right. Looks like our winner on that poll is Fences. I will share that results with you now. You should be seeing them on your Nearpod. All right, we still have two people who didn't answer. That's okay. Please answer if you can. All right, but that gives you kind of a little idea of where everybody's thoughts are. So, ladies and gentlemen, what I want to do now is if you click on that link that I put in the chat, it should take you to a page that looks like this, right? You can see here we have 11 things you should know about August Wilson. And we have some kind of key background details, some photos of his plays, right? There's one of Fences, right? Here's another one similar to Ma Rainey's Black Bottom called Jitney, all right? Some other ones. And if you see some familiar faces, that's because you'll notice this guy who plays Denzel Washington's character that you saw in that trailer in the original play is James Earl Jones, right? Who is the voice of Darth Vader, the voice of Mufasa. He's in The Sandlot, if you've ever seen any of those. So, ladies and gentlemen, what I want you to do here is go through this article, and then like I put in the chat, I want you to tell me five important things that you learned about August Wilson, all right? You can send them to me individually in the chat, individually, so that nobody else is seeing everybody else's answers and nobody's kind of stealing from anybody. If you have a hard time keeping track of stuff in the chat, you can also put it in an email or a Google Doc and send that to me. If you work better doing it by hand, you can write them down by hand and send me a picture. All right. But this is what I'd like to see from you before we leave today. We got about 15 minutes. So I'm going to turn you guys loose on this. Again, you're heading to that link that I just put in the chat, reading through that, and then tell me five important things that you learned about August Wilson. You can send them to me privately in the chat. Make sure you number each one so I can keep track. Or you can send them to me in a Google Doc or an email. If you keep track of them better that way. Okay, let's go ahead and get started on this. I will check back in about 10 minutes and kind of see where everybody's at. And if you have questions as you're doing this, don't be afraid to give me a shout. All right, thank you. All right, welcome. Just to clarify, because I'm seeing some stuff come in the chat, remember that you are telling me five important things about August Wilson, the playwright, not about James Earl Jones, okay? If you're kind of lumping them together, that's okay, but I've only seen a few of these come in the chat here so far, so remember, you are telling me five important things you learned about August Wilson from that article that I've put a link to. Now, I know I did say if you want to do it by hand and send me a picture, if you want to put it in an email or a Google Doc, that's fine too. But just make sure that that's what you are working on right now so I get that from you before we leave today, all right? Still got about 10 minutes, okay? If you are, in fact, doing yours on a Google Doc or an email or you're not putting it in the chat, if you could just let me know that in the chat so I know everybody is at least working on this. That would be great. You can just message me privately in the chat and let me know, hey, I'm doing mine on this or whatever. If you are putting yours in the chat, again, make sure you message them to me privately and try and number each one so that I can keep track of these. And again, remember, you're telling me five important things you learned about August Wilson from that article, okay? Keep up the good work. If you have questions, give me a shout. All right, I've gotten two from Jair so far. He's been the only one, so let's keep up the good work, and I want to see some more of these coming into the chat here. All right, y'all, good job. Thank you. Right, awesome. Getting a few more in these. I got all Zanelia's, and that's fine. You know, I know some of us are doing all these at once. Some of us are putting them as we go. Go for it. Very cool. Very cool. So I got some from Jair. I got Zanelia's. Keep these coming. Like I said, if you're doing them somewhere else, like in an email or on a Google Doc, try and let me know that if you can, so that I know where to expect each of these, all right, from everybody. If you finish this, if you give me all five and you have still not sent me your filmmaking web quest that was due for the progress report, you can finish that and send that to me. And let me double check that I don't need to share it with anybody that is in here that I haven't shared it with. No, I think everybody in here has it. Yeah. I think maybe except Jairi. So, Jairi, I shared that web quest with you. Everybody else in here, I think you should have it. Let me double check on Talia and Ike. Okay, so Talia and Ike and Jairi, you guys should all have that web quest now. Everybody else, I believe, should already have it. So again, when you finish these five August Wilson facts, if you haven't sent me that web quest yet, you can finish that. And Zanelli, I'm seeing your stuff in the chat now. Okay. So you gotta know. Yeah, so don't forget, on that web quest, the initial one that I share with you, you won't be able to edit. You have to make a copy of it, and then you can edit on that one, right? So you go up where it says file, hit make a copy, hit okay, and then the copy of it should come up, and you should be able to edit on that one. And that's just a precaution I do so that everybody's not working on the original at once, okay? Thank you, guys. All right, still looking for these five facts from the rest of us. All right, I've gotten ones from Zanelia. I've got ones from Jair. Thank you, good job. All right, everybody else, I'm still waiting on. All right, and like I said, if you're putting them in an email or a Google Doc, or you're doing them by hand and gonna send me a picture, that's fine. Just trying to let me know that if you can, so I know where to see these from you. All right, we'll give it about maybe another minute and then we'll try and wrap up here for today, but keep up the good work with this. All right, and if you are still working on this and you can't finish before we wrap up class, just send it to me as soon as you are done. As long as I have it by the end of the day, you will be good to go in terms of participation for today. All right. All right, y'all. Sorry about that. Getting a few more of these. Kanaya, I just got yours. Thank you. All right. I got your email. Jerry, I got yours in the chat. Excellent job. All right, y'all. Really good work. So before we wrap up here, those of us who were able to get through this, what is one thing of, you know, when you were looking at all those different things to put in your list of five, what's one thing that stood out to you as interesting or that you didn't expect when you were reading about August Wilson? Somebody give me one thing that stood out to you before we wrap up here today. You can tell me in the chat or you can come off mute and tell me verbally, but what's one thing that you read and you were like, oh, wow, that's cool. Jair said that his works delve into the Black American experience. Yeah, that is crucial. That's why I wanted to focus on his plays and movies based on his plays for this film study class rather than the Shakespeare one that was, you know, attached with Summit. I thought, you know, rather than read something else written by an old dead white guy, you know, let's read something that Miss Kelsey agrees. Let's read something that's actually, you know, still resonant to, you know, all of you and what's going on today. So really cute, really good one. And something that stood out to me was that, you know, he wrote those 10 plays, but he never set out to write that kind of cycle of 10 plays. He just started writing plays and that's what eventually happened. All right. Yeah, and that's another one too, Kanaya. A really good point is, you know, actors that were in his plays like James Earl Jones, like Alice Wilson, right? They went on to have, you know, very, very big careers. Like, you know, before James Earl Jones was, you know, Darth Vader and Mufasa, he was in an August Wilson play. And if there's any other sci-fi fans here that like The Matrix, like Mr. V, the woman who plays the Oracle in the first two Matrix movies, she was in the original production of Fences, all right? And, you know, we see that is a super common thing, you know what I mean? How some people can start in the theater and then, you know, start to blow up in movies. You know, look at what's happened with Hamilton now, right? So we have like Daveed Diggs and Leslie Odom Jr. And they were obviously, of course, doing stuff before they were cast in Hamilton, but now, you know, we're starting to see them in major, like, movies and TV shows and stuff. So really cool, very good point. All right, anything else? All right, well, thank you guys. I thank you. Miss Kelsey thanks you. Miss Kelsey's turtleneck thanks you. And really good job. Thank you to everybody who shared. I will see you all again on Monday. Don't forget all school assembly tomorrow at 11:30 to give out some shout outs for progress reports. And if you still haven't sent me your five things and your web quest, make sure I get those as soon as possible. All right. I will be in the lab from 1 to 3 if you have questions about anything else. But other than that, I will see you on Monday. And really good job. Stay safe in the snow. All right. Thank you, guys.